have so many donations, we all have heard. Blood donation, helping someone to study, helping someone to get married, many things in life. But of all the donations, if you look at, organ donation probably stands the highest level. Because we might have any amount of money. Many things can be bought, even in health, with money. But what we cannot certainly buy is an organ. This has to be donated. And we know today that there are so many diseases which affects different important organs of body, like kidney, liver, lungs, heart, there are multiple things. And when these organs finally end their life, they do not function anymore. Some we can support for some time, but many organs we certainly cannot. There comes a time in our life they need to be replaced with the good ones. But where do they come from? Now, current technology, certainly nothing is very close where we can grow these organs in tissue culture and implant them. Only way we can get them today is by donation. Now, when I talk of donation, you know, who can donate? Any healthy young individual whose organ is good can donate, practically. Now, when it comes to my own specialty, for example, heart, there are so many conditions which probably make heart dysfunction over a period of time. Some come from birth, some we acquire as we live our life. Now, many things now we have heard, coronary artery disease, heart attacks. We have different treatments for that, but eventually some of these patients would land up with heart failure where none of our known therapies would help them to survive longer. There are small children who are born with weakness of the muscles of the heart, called as cardiomyopathy. There, I think at certain stage in their life, there's nothing which works. The only thing which can make them survive and see the next years probably is a heart transplantation. Unlike other organ donation, organ like heart comes only from brain dead donors. There's nothing called cadaveric donors at this moment. Now, brain dead donors, yes, as you know, a one child or a one person has to survive, one person has to go. That is how it works in the heart, unlike kidney or probably liver, to some extent even lung. But once a new heart comes into one's own chest, his life completely changes. He can be a normal fellow for next 10 years, 15 years. There are patients who have gone beyond 20 years with a single organ. So, gift of an organ is certainly more than gift of a life. You imagine a child who otherwise would have been dead can lead a normal life. There are so many of them today, even in our own city, who have got this in our own hospital, who have got this and leading completely normal, satisfied life. Unfortunately, now you look at the amount of people who require it, but amount of people who are donating it, there is no match at all. Now, every single hospital probably would have around 8 or 10 patients on the waiting list, but on average, we may get one or two donations in a month in a big city like Bangalore, where we do see significant amount of people having brain deaths. Instead of putting these organs to mud or burn them, I think we probably should start thinking towards donation. That can cause a huge difference. All of us can donate different organs. Suppose if I am little young, I can probably donate all my organs. If I am less than 50-55, still I can donate my kidneys. If my heart condition is good, yes, heart can be donated. My lungs can be donated. My liver can be donated. It is possible. Only I think one age crosses, say 60 or 65, those organs probably may not be the best one to go into an younger person's body. The important message we want to give on this important day is that think about organ donation, plan about it. There are legal ways of going about it. We can designate that in an unfortunate event of my death, probably my organs can be donated. We can pledge our organs even before, you know, we see a bad end.